question time from the Nigerian diaspora. Wherever you are in the diaspora, we'll bring it to you on Question Time. We got the questions, so it's time for that conversation. Question Time from the Nigerian diaspora.
Do you feel your father's legacy is being respected?
My father's greatest legacy are the people to whom he gave opportunities and their achievements.
Wherever you are in the diaspora, we'll bring it to you on Question Time.
So as you find you just in a passenger, need someone like a passenger, treat them all like a passenger. No, you say you're a passenger, so find you just in a passenger, treat someone like a passenger, treat them all like a passenger. No, you say you're a
all summer. All entertainers, all the clubs I went to, all the cinemas I went to, there was one thing constant. Everybody had the Afro model brand. Ladies and gentlemen, man himself, Mr. Emmanuel Nax, CEO, Afro Model.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for having us.
Thank
you very much. How was your summer? That's my first question.
Summer was really, really busy.
I can see.
It was really, really busy for me because there was a lot going on. So much going on my clothing line, you know, it was really, really busy for me, I must say.
For us looking from the outside in, it seemed like a mini takeover. Is that how you planned it?
Oh my God, everything just happened just like that. That's the way I'm going to say, everything just happened like that. I just want to keep everyone get everyone to be like, wow, like surprise everyone. That's just me. Because I love surprises.
But I would have thought like there was a gap in the market. People needed people wearing a lot of print, but people were not, you know, people wearing seeing this print is different from what you're doing.
Yes, it's very, very different because obviously I've got so much friends, and even myself, I don't really like wearing the Afro-European outfit. I never liked it because the way it was made, you know, is kind of old-fashioned for me. So I thought to myself, I have to bring it back to back to our modern age for people that couldn't wear the old school, the old style, to start loving the Afro-European brand.
I just want to talk about the brand, Afro Model brand, and all the stuff I've seen this summer. I'm seeing it in front of me. I'm being stalked by this brand. Now, how long have you been working on this?
Actually, I've been into clothing since 2011, officially. Yeah, and then actually this Afro-European brand, I started working on it last year. I got inspiration last year, and I've done all the sketches and research with different factories to get the perfect fabric for what I really need.
So wait, you were in fashion since 2011, but what role were you playing? Were you in the background?
Yeah, actually, when I say I was in fashion since 2011, it means I do style artists.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a personal style artist. I do personal shopping for like celebrities as well. That's what I do. Like, obviously, I know what the people want. So that's why I've worked in this industry for a very long time. So I know what the people want. So it's now time for me to deliver in my own brand.
We're going to do some name drop. because I'm straight entertainment. So I've seen some people and I said like, oh, I dig this person's style, you know. So tell us, who have you been styling on the side that they've been looking good and they haven't called your name?
So many of them, you know. So many, I've styled so many artists, the UK-based artists, the Nigerian artists as well, coming from Nigeria. Yeah, I've styled a lot. Like this guy, Humble Smith.
Yeah.
Yeah, I styled him in 2015. I started in 2015, early 2015, when he came to do his music video here in London. All what he was wearing was from Afro Model UK.
So let me ask you, if you had to put a finger on your inspiration,
mm-hmm.
would it be bringing the style back, you know, would it be pushing the culture? You know, you didn't like the way it points or anything, but what would you say was your inspiration just to go on Afro Mod?
For me, as in, I'm retouching the old style, like giving the Afro Model touch.
Yeah.
That's what I would say. I always say that, I give it the retouch, you know, for like people like 18, 19, 20, 25, at least they could be comfortable wearing the Afro-European outfit.
So it's more European flavor, but with really African.
Yes, 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 yes. So it's in between the two. You know what I mean? Like the fabric is European. Yeah, the European fabric with even the stitches are like is European, which is from Italy. Yeah, the stitches are Italian stitches, which is so to fit, like slim fits, you know what I mean, with the Afro, you know, the print and everything, just to finish it up. That's why it's called the Afro-European style.
I have to say, you know, with all the pictures and when I was seeing everybody, the pictures don't do as much justice. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to say, you know, we're going to go up close so you can see that there's like, what do you call this fabric?
Yeah, this one is Polish linen. That's what it's called. It's called Polish linen. Yeah, which is, if you know more about fabric, this is one of the top fabric now in the market, which is very expensive. And
with the print fabric,
yeah,
everybody's doing print. Topshop is doing print. Yeah. Everybody's doing print. Now, they have a cut. You know, they have a cut, which I would call a general cut.
Yeah.
You know, you have a cut, which I may permit me for calling it designer's cut. Is that what you, you know? What were they doing wrong? And you said, no, this is not.
Actually, I like to stand out from the crowd. If you know me very well, anywhere I step in, I always get that 100% attention. Okay. I like to stand out from the crowd. So whereby I came up with something that when you wear it, no matter what print anybody's wearing, you're going to stand out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? There's so many testimonies, so many examples, like, couple of my friends, like when they go out wedding or something, they always call me like, Afro man, what happened? What have you done to this clothes? Like, everybody want to take photos with me. Everybody want to, like, wow. You know, not one, not two, not three, not four. You know what I mean?
From different countries.
From different places, like, wow. Oh, you look, even the pink, you know, the pink, you know, people are scared of wearing pink. Like, guys, you know what? You know, people are scared of wearing pink.
I'm but scared of wearing
my
pink
with black stars. Man, that's the most selling out of all. It goes really, really good. As of now, I don't have any more pinks at the moment, but I'm still waiting for some more orders.
You make guys wear pink. Now, I need to ask you about your collection. You know, your collection quickly. I've seen the stars, you know, and I have seen just mainly men.
Mm-hmm.
And every time I see you, you seem to be, anytime I see your picture,
yeah,
you seem to be the only one wearing this, wearing, what is this, and what does the stars represent?
Actually, the star, as in, the star, what I thought about the stars is versatile, because even a Christians, they love stars, which represent, like, brightness, like, a star, shining star.
Yeah.
Even the Muslims, they love stars, yeah, is their symbol, so I have to be versatile, so that's why I came up with the stars.
And you designed it yourself?
Yes, I did everything from the scratch.
Now I'm from Nigeria. You're from Nigeria,
so. Of course.
Now I'm from Edo State, and you're from
Delta State.
Now this look like my Igwe. Is that?
Yeah, that's very traditional. It's like the, you know, the feather. You know the feather.
Yes.
The one the chiefs they normally put on their hats.
The title.
Yeah, chiefs. Title chief. Yeah, that's that. If someone that knows very well, it means Africa. It represents Africa in a way.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's like our roots, where we came from.
In your community, mm-hmm, do you find out that which one do they go for more? Do they want this?
Actually, yeah, the stars goes very, very, like, when the star came out, it was like bam bam bam. When this one came out, it was like, oh my god, I'm dead. Afro, you killed it. Like, people were like, wow, this is amazing. This is, as in, they've never seen something like this before, so it's something different.
Question time from the Edo diaspora, reaching out to all Edos across the diaspora. Question Time has teamed up with Edo Connect to bring you a regular news summary from Edo State and Edo's in diaspora. On Edo Connect, we got fashion blogger Emil Saboye. We got Monique Igwe live from Edo State with the mood on ground. Why not get your voice heard by recording a video message on your phone and sending it to Edo Connect? The greatest celebration in Edo State is coming to London, celebrating the coronation of Oba Ewari II, the 40th Oba of the Great Benin Kingdom. EQ Events presents with Edo Connect. We have the Afema Union UK, the Asan Union UK, the Benin UK, the Odionwe Council. Special guests include Prince Ekme Eradiawa, Prince Omoregbe Eradiawa, Mr. Ayo Ambrose Ali, Chief Steve Dunstan, Red Carpet by Amy Osaboye, performances by Uyano, Fumi Shitu, Wendy Goffis, Edo Heartbeat, and Corinne the Lion. The date is Saturday, 7th January 2017. The venue is the Lynx Community Centre, 353 Rotherhithe New Road, SE16 3HF. Please book your tickets in time to avoid disappointment. And remember, don't be late.
Are you waiting for me now? Hey, hey, don't be waiting for me now.
Everywhere I've gone, all my friends in music, Como, Dizzy, Atompan, you name them, it's mainly entertainers that I see wearing your outfit. Now, is this promotional or is this by choice?
Actually, the outfit is meant for everyone. Everyone. Artists, non-artists, everyone wears the collection. But I think the artists, they love it because it's something extraordinary. Should I say that? It's something unique. Like, they love it. They want to showcase it in their music video. They want to use it for photo shoots, so they are loving it.
So that's why But let's talk about, there's other people. I don't have it, just people watching, you understand? Yeah. I don't have one. Yeah. But what about the women? Because when you go through your website and your pictures that you put up, I see a woman's picture and I see even a kid's picture wearing your brand. Are these part of your collection for 2016?
Yes, they are fully part of my collection. I got the women collection as well, in black, in white, in blue as well. You know, all colors for the women. Yeah, as you see for the men, as it is for the women.
Let's talk about moving the brand, actual moving it just beyond your website. You have a presence in the UK now, at least in London. I see it so much. You're from Nigeria.
Of course.
Where are you going first? Nigeria or America?
Actually, because I'm from Nigeria originally, and I got so much huge demands from the people from Nigeria, whereby I think 100% I will be starting from Nigeria. Yeah.
When you go out to Nigeria, you're going to use the same strategy?
Actually, people from Nigeria, they've been buying a lot. So obviously I'm going there to do a couple of shoots, like photo shoots in Nigeria at least, to showcase the African culture, which is the whole natural African thing, not like studio shoot, like more like outdoor shoot.
Yeah.
Then from there I got a couple of TV interviews as well, you know, just to let everyone know that, yeah, the man is here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So all what you've been seeing on TV, internet or whatever, the main guy is here. So you know what I mean? So just to draw their attention. To know, yes, I'm here, and the Afro Model UK is coming to Nigeria fully, like a branch in Nigeria. Yeah,
you know, do you
like
you
a fashion room, like a fashion room or fashion house? Yeah.
So you have you have models lined up.
Yeah, actually, I got a couple of models and a couple of celebrities as well, like singers, actors that are ready to wear my brand for the photos. Yeah,
from Nigeria. Which part exactly first? Are you going, where are you going?
No, I'm going straight to Lagos. That's the center of excellence. Yeah. That's where things happen.
And you're going
there. Yeah, going there. You're going straight to straight to Las Giddy.
Yeah. for the girls, for the girls watching, for the female, how close are we to a proper female outfit, just the way you're catering for the males now?
Yes, actually, we got five different designs for ladies. Yeah, but I'm dropping them slowly and slowly. You know, I got three now on the website. I got three ladies' outfit now on the website. They can check and see. And then slowly, I'm gonna put more photos for them to see and purchase. Yeah.
We're talking about the website so much. Please, can you tell us exactly the website address and how things go?
Yeah, you can check out my website on www.afromodel.co.uk.
And you can place orders.
Yeah, straight away. You can place your orders straight away. A credit card, debit card, PayPal, whatever. Yeah, just go there. And very easy to access, straightforward. It's not complicated at all.
Let's talk about some juicy stuff. Now, everywhere I go, I see you. I saw you, O2. You're taking over people's shows. You go to O2, people want to watch film. You show up, you know, people are watching your film.
Of course.
If you went for an interview, they say, where do you see yourself in 5 years? I don't think you need that much time. Where do you see this brand and in the next years?
Actually, as in, it's going to go really, really far. Like, you might stop at Heathrow Airport and you see Afromodel UK.
That much, you see?
Heathrow Airport. And just all over the world. Yeah, it's going places. Yeah, it's going places and it's going to go places. Everybody has their strengths, you know. Everybody has their selling points.
Yeah.
I think I got that special touch.
Yes.
You know what I mean? And people always love anything that involves Afromodel UK.
But would you employ some of these up-and-coming designers that...
Of course. I'll give everyone a room. Like, come on. There's always room for people to come. I can't eat alone. Come on, I'm not greedy. Yeah, why not? When the time comes, obviously, there'll be a lot of space, opportunity for people to hump in, innit?
But what are you... Because you are self-driven, you're self-taught, you've been in the background for a long time. What are you looking for in people who want to work with you? What must they
actually have? They have to be self-motivated. They have to believe in themselves, sure, first of all, before they can believe in any other brand.
Right.
You have to believe in yourself, what you can do, you know what I mean? Like, what you can achieve, like, what you can do. And should I say, don't give up your dream. Whatever you think you believe that you can do, please do it. You know what I mean? Don't listen to people, what people will say, like, oh, I don't think you can do that, bruv. Just do it. That's all I have to say. Because, you know, people, so many talk, oh, there's too much fashion going on, oh, this. But I never, as in that, never killed my dream. I'm this kind of person. When I say I want to do something, I do it to the last. That's me.
We're gonna take a look at the website. We're gonna take a look at the shows, because all these things I'm telling you, you might not believe me, you know. But just before we finally leave you, what have you learned from being in the background to being the main man?
Yes. Actually, I've learned so much. Like, I know what the people want. You know, you being in the background, so you know what the people really, really, really want. And that's what I'm doing. I'm just going straight to what they want, not beating around the bush. You know, so that's it. That's why you see everybody want to wear Afromodel UK. That's just the secret.
I'm wearing it. Next show, watch out. I'm wearing it. Afromodel. Thank you. We're going to look at the website. We're going to see all these guys wearing... Leaving me behind, if I may say. Leaving me behind and staying like that. And now it's my time. And if you want to, anybody who wants to contact you, send you emails that they're up and coming designers. They have free. What you're saying. What email address
can they? Yeah, they can reach me on afromodel@yahoo.com. Straight up.
Send your CV.
Yes. Send
your resume.
Don't worry. Baby, pana. Anywhere that you go, I could follow you to go. Baby, pana. I say like cassava, I get to be cassava. Baby, pana. My love for you will never die. Will never die.
Viva, Viva, oh baby, Viva, Viva. Baby, you too sweet, you forever. My baby dance it to the lagwaja. Make I take you to Babalada. Viva, Viva, oh baby, Viva, Viva. Baby, you too sweet, you forever. My baby dance it to the lagwaja. Make I take you to Babalada. So love is a beautiful thing. Can you dey cool my temper? Love is a wonderful, tender feeling. You dey give me ginger. So baby, dancey, dancey, dancey. If it's in your eyes, they give me life, oh, oh. I could give the love the thanks, oh. For the sake, for the sake of love, oh. Hey, baby, leave it up, I leave it up, oh. I never leave it up, I leave it up, oh. If I can say, I could kill you, oh. Hey, show you love that you never seen before. For like you give me love, oh. Now you the catch in my shot. For your sake, I go go touch you. We go drive around you for my Porsche.
For those people who, for those prolific Instagram people, please can you tell them how to find you online?
Yeah, on Instagram you can check me out on Afromodel UK. That's my handle on Instagram. On Snapchat as well, if you want to be really, really active, like want to be a stalker, Snapchat on Afromodel UK as well.
For like you give me love, oh. Now you the catch in my shot, oh. For your sake, I go go touch you. We go drive around you for my Porsche. Baby pana, they say you like you all I get you all. Baby pana, anywhere that you go I can follow you to go. Baby pana, they say you like cassava, I get the big cassava. Baby pana, my love for you will never die, will never die. Viva, Viva, oh baby, Viva, Viva. Baby, you too sweet, you forever. My baby dance to the lagwaja. Make I take you to Babalada. Viva, Viva, oh baby, Viva, Viva. Baby, you too sweet, you forever. My baby dance to the lagwaja. Make I take you to Babalada. So love is a beautiful thing. Can you dey cool my temper? Love is a wonderful, tender feeling. You dey give me
and all dressed up, my Afro Model game. See the stars? Everyone loves stars. Even Donald Trump loves stars. I'm feeling good. Look, Afro Model, can I take this away?
For like you give me love. Now you the catch in my shot. For your sake, I go go touch you. We go drive around you for my Porsche. Baby pana, they say you like you all I get you all like. Baby pana, anywhere that you go I can follow you to go. Baby pana,
Mr. Afromodel, thank you very much. Good luck, you know. Don't leave us at the airport terminal when they're looking at we're there.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, bro. Okay.
Special guests include Prince Ekme Eradiawa, Prince Omoregbe Eradiawa, Mr. Ayo Ambrose Ali, Chief Steve Dunstan, Red Carpet by Amy Osaboye, performances by Uyano, Fumi Shitu, Wendy Goffis, Edo Heartbeat, and Corin the Lion. The date is Saturday, 7th January 2017. The venue is the Lynx Community Center, 353 Rotherhide New Road, SE16 3HF. Please book your tickets in time to avoid disappointment. And remember, don't be late.
Are you waiting for me now? Hey, hey, don't be waiting for me now.